Hello, fellow gunners. I'm going to make another VR. I'm going to make this one out to Phil M. Rivers. Phil's having a 250 subscriber giveaway. And he wants to know what's your rarest gun that you have or you've had. Now, me being the trader that I've been, I was at a garage sale one day, and I noticed over on the grass there was a firearm, and it was in pieces, many, many pieces, well, as many as a hinge gun could be. And I went over and was looking at it, and it was different. Like I said, it was a hinge gun, but the forearm was over here, and the butt was over here, and the receiver was over here, and the barrel was over here, and the woman come up to me, and of course she did her little spiel, and she's trying to tell me it was one of the first buffalo guns ever made, which I chuckled. Had it been in some other caliber than 44 mag, I probably would have bought that. Like a 50 100 sharps or whatever. But it was a 44 mag, and it had a semi octagon barrel, and you know, I looked at it, and it was actually somebody had made it. It was a shotgun receiver, and had the bottom part of the shotgun with a 44 barrel welded to it. They done a good job. That's all I got to say. They done a good job. It was drilled and tapped for a scope, and me liking my optics, I scoped it. But the butt wasn't finished. And when I mean it wasn't finished, it didn't have any way to attach it to the receiver. And I don't remember how the forearm was, but I do remember the buttstock, because that was a pretty good procedure to getting that buttstock to fit on that receiver and get it attached. But I bore a hole through the side of the buttstock, and then drilled a hole from there down to where it'd go into the receiver and screw into the thing. And then I covered up my hose with two silver dollars. It was actually pretty sharp when I got done with the gun. And I actually killed a little forkhorn with it. I was impressed. It was sleeting this year, and seen fresh tracks, so I followed it. Actually, I set my son to follow the deer, and I snuck around the back in front of the deer and cut it off and shot it from under him. But I'd have to say that was probably the rarest gun I've ever had. Little old homemade single shot 44 mag. It would shoot 180 grain bullets really good, but you get anything bigger than that and they tumbled. Well, thanks guys for watching. And make sure you check out Phil M. Rivers. He's a good old boy. Check him out, guys. Catch you in the next video.